another video on Rico's World, and today I'll be telling you how does the most important life, at least for sticking or most important part of life, work. So the thing is called glue gun. So this is a picture of a glue gun, at least the teardown picture of a glue gun. So before I tell you how does this magical thing work, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And of course, smash that like button. So let's get into it straight now. This is a picture of a open glue gun. So as right over here, you can see a wire connecting it. Oh, let's become the electricity that flows so it will be better for us to understand. So becoming electricity, the switch is on and we go up to the two cap type thingies as current. You know, what are these? These are LEDs, not caps or a silicone thing. So some people may be thinking that's silicone, but you guessed it wrong. It is high voltage LEDs that can withstand a high amount of voltage. So now let's shrink down the way. So the wire is shrinking, is sneaking from behind the trigger. And what is this? This orange type thingy? Oh, it's copper. So the copper wires are connected with the heater. So that's not, you know, some people may be thinking like, what is that? How can that be a heater? You know, it is a heater, okay? So my glue gun, which I have in my home, is actually 38 volts because, you know, I don't know how much this like heater is, how much voltage can this heater withstand. And you can see that the heater is connected with the aluminum barrel. You know, many people saw it and many people did not. So that, why is that made out of aluminium? Okay, giving you 5 seconds to guess. Ha, just kidding, not 5 seconds. It is like an aluminium barrel because the aluminium can heat up to a really high temperature. So the glue sticks which are in are made out of high quality rubber. And you know, to burn down high quality rubber, we need quite some temperature, bro. And after that, you see that the aluminium barrel is connected with the nozzle. Yeah, not the airplane nozzle. You know, it kind of looks like an airplane nozzle or a pencil, you know? So it looks like a pencil more than an airplane nozzle. Ha, anyways, so that's the place from where the molten jello comes out. Now I'll be thinking like, what is a molten jello? You know, as we push the trigger somehow pushes the glue stick inside the aluminium barrel, and the high temperature just turns it to molten lava. Not molten lava, it just turns it to a sticky jello type substance. But you know, that sticky jello type substance isn't what we should mess with. So, you know, even if we press the trigger more times, then what happens? The trigger pushes it more and the glue stick pushes the jello or molten jello out through the nozzle. And you know, that's, it's done. But now you'll be thinking, what is this thing on the side? Yeah, you guessed it correct. It's a tension spring. So what is a tension spring? Here's a picture of a tension spring. Now, here's a spring chart. There are 4 types of springs. You know, as I know, there are 4 types of springs. So, tension spring, which is used in the glue gun, and a torsion spring, which is used in clothespin, the compression spring. Ha! I can see a compression spring, but it's just in front of me. So, you know, my RC car has a compression spring. So, you know, if you step on it, you know, sometimes people step on RC cars. Like, who are they? You know, just kidding. So just for safety, it has compression springs, and to save the car, you know, it has compression springs. And the spiral spring is the spring which are inside the motors or mechanisms of those small little pullback toys or pullback cars, you know? So, well, how do those pullback toys work? I mean, I won't tell that in this video, so I'll tell you in another video. So, you know, as you pull it back, it just goes front, and as this, like, unfolds, it just, like, continues running with the momentum, you know? That's what I know all about it. So now let's get back to this glue gun. So now over here you can see a teeny meeny hook on the rod type thingy. You know, it's not rod, okay? It's not the ice cream rod, okay? So the big rectangular, it's not rectangular because it has its edges curved, you know, whatever you want to call it. It has a hook on it. And you know, that's where the first like hole of the tension spring is hooked into, and the second one is just locked by the cover, the outer cover, you know, the casing. I don't know how, so you know, that's much I don't know about the glue gun. And right from here you can see another rod, and that rod has a rectangular thing and another rectangular thing popping out of it. You know, that's not a rectangular. When you look at it from the behind, it's actually a square with the top two parts curved. So, you know, it has a hole on it. And from the down, it has like a small little stick type popping out from it. And you know, that's the thing that pushes the glue stick inside the barrel and turns it into molten jello and takes it out. Ha! That was so easy. You know, we like went through all the parts of the glue gun. And where are these sticks over here? Ha! You got it correct. They are hands, or stands, I mean. They are stands, okay? So they are stands that help the glue gun to heat up. But you know, some people may be thinking we could just keep it. You know, so there are some people who like do the work with glue gun on the bed or on the iron table, but you know, that's why we have this over here. And even I also saw this on my glue gun. So if we keep it, like if we lay it down on the table, what can happen is, all of you guys know that an iron table is always made out of cloth. And then there's a layer of sponge, and under that is a layer of metal plate. But when we keep this, or the most heated part of the glue gun, on cloths, then what happens is that, you know, it can burn off. And if your tablecloth or iron tablecloth is like synthetic, then it can even get fire. And why did I say that this is the most heated part of the glue gun? Because you know, it can form blisters in your skin or burn up anything really quick. So children who are using this may have to be under 10 years, I mean above or the age of 10 years, but the children under 10 years should always use it under the supervision of adults, you know? So that's all about the glue gun. Now we're telling you some fun facts about the glue gun. Okay, the fun facts will be fun, okay? And it's fun time! Okay, fact number one. Did you know that Scalds George invented the glue gun in 1954? It was like a jumbo glue gun because, you know, we did not have those compact engineering at those times or compact mechanisms. Fact number two, you know, the last fact, unfortunately. Okay, whatever. So, did you know that a part of humanity would not exist without the glue gun. So, you know, glue guns are really often seen in houses in the modern days. So, you know, that's all. And if you did like the video and learned something new, don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe. So, here are my Facebook and Instagram pages. Through these, you can follow me on Facebook and Instagram. So, I guess, for now, bye, guys. And I again say, hope you guys like the video.